Really?
I would say, yeah, I mean, flooding and coastal erosion. So one of the bigger things is essentially a lot of the increased storms and wave energy actually can erode the coastline. And so what people typically do is dredge sand and dump it on shore to widen the beach, and that's called beach nourishment. It's not a sustainable practice. It's not the best for the marine environment. It's a $1 billion industry nationwide, millions of dollars per county typically, of just dumping sand. And really what that is a band-aid. It's a quick fix to the long-term problem of coastal erosion. And that's where, you know, again, we're really proud to be stepping into the space of trying to design solutions that are more sustainable, not only for the environment, but the actual long-term goal of meeting that problem. And so that's where those breakwaters can come into play. And we're seeing a lot of universities, as well as, you know, DARPA, which is the defense agency of the US for research, allocated $60 million to research breakwaters to protect Navy bases on the water. And UM is the one doing that research on that project. So we're really excited to be, you know, one of UM's partners, and we work with them quite frequently. And just watching as this research unfolds, they have incredible work that they're doing that will really advance the state of how we address coastal resiliency moving forward.
So you had mentioned that us humans are more
Reactive.
reactionary and we're thinking less long term. How psychologically can we have discussions long term where people understand ramifications?
You know, I think that comes from relationship building, like even within people, and that's why I fell in love with using art, because I think it's a storytelling element. Sometimes, again, people from like a very primal instinct, right? You're worried about yourself and your circle, your immediate space. And unless something is directly impeding on that, you might not be thinking about it or care or feel personally connected. And so the importance of creating these conversations that not only do, like, bring awareness, right? A lot of people are aware. They know about the problem, but they don't know ways that they can make a direct impact, help, or, you know, influence other change. I think we're needing this, what I call kind of a societal shift in perception in their relationships. And that's why we try to use art to connect deeply to communities, so it's more meaningful and it can add value that can tell a story across time that could perhaps give that different psychological connection back to the ocean. And not just the ocean, I think with any environmental project, we're more disconnected from nature than we have ever been. And I mean, aside from all the doom and gloom, I'm always an advocate of, like, I think we can solve the world's toughest things right now.